We have a Twitter god with us on the stage in a few minutes, but he also calls himself hashtag failed intellectual, and Eric Jaruzelski's universe is somewhere in between. He's better known as Nine Quarterly, and without him, Twitter would have been a bit less funny in the past 10 years and a bit less wise, perhaps. Fittingly to 10 years of Republica, he compiled a best-of, a sort of listicle of all the things he learned in those 10 years. Please welcome with me Eric Jaruzelski, better known as Nine Quarterly.
Hello. Thank you. Welcome. I'm glad to be back. I want to speak German. I hope that's okay. And I want to come over as just as intellectual and as sexy as all of you. And I thought German would be the best way to do that. Although I'm going to keep a bit of an accent to seem authentic. I wanted to do something different this time. I think what you know of me is usually not very optimistic, maybe a bit less inspirational sometimes, but I wanted to think semi-utopistically today, and my talk is about the possibilities of a very old technology called Twitter. I think it's dying at the moment, or maybe it's already died, whichever way you want to look at it. And I've been looking very carefully, I've been following it very carefully at Republica, and what I've already noticed is what you can learn from Twitter, and the learnings from Twitter are very important for a conference like ours, where many friends of the internet gather. And I wanted to encourage you to stay with Twitter, because I believe that a lot of what is happening at Republica might not even happen if this community didn't exist in the way it does. But first, I have to think back to the past few years. I think Republica always starts on a Monday, and I always call it the best Monday of the year. I'm a huge fan of it, and I thought it was great. First, my compliments to the organizers, to Markus. There's an interesting new partner this year. There are always media partners and sponsors, but I thought it was great that one of the German secret services is the media partners of this year. It's not really, but they're having a conference at the same time. I thought this really contributed something. And it's not like the fans of the internet don't discriminate against the old media. Another partner is German Mail, and of course this includes encryption. And I personally had the honor of appearing as a media partner in these past few days. And I tried to give the world some glimpses into the world of Republica. Unfortunately, the few tweets that got read the most were this, for one, and this. And I must admit, the media partner used the first hashtag the first time. But this can happen if you're a Twitter god. I want to apologize for this. So the first day is always a bit tough, and on the second day you may be a bit hungover or a bit tired. You don't always you know, some you miss a few things. I noticed this yesterday on Twitter, the sketch notes. There are sketch notes for many of the talks. Here are some examples. I'm very, very impressed. There's going to be a sketch note. I've already prepared the sketch note for my talk. It's, you see it here, nothing. I'm not always very self-confident because I don't really have a lot to say as a semi-idealist. And that's why I was very happy when I came here today. I noticed that we now have found a home on the internet, and I'm very happy about that. But my subject is reflections on a damaged Twitter life. Are you getting the allusion? Yeah, I'm noticing a few very bitter or depressed ancient academics. You remember this is a play on Adorno. Was a huge inspiration, his aphorisms. And it's a pleasure to be able to look at Republika and Twitter from this perspective, especially in Berlin, because it's been top. It used to be top secret, but Adorno is still alive, and he lives in Berlin, and he takes the U7. Or does he? Come on, I mean, there are certain similarities here. And next to him, there's what seems to be a reader of Adorno. I can recommend this. I've been trying for the past few years as a Twitter phenomenon to take some of the fear of Adorno, because he's not always as depressing. And you can read it. It's a good idea to read it. And this is my schedule as a Twitter god. This is my first commandment as a Twitter god. This is one of the quotes of a quote of his you might know. There's no life in the wrong or anywhere else. There's no right life in the wrong life or anywhere. But I wanted to be a bit more positive, and I thought more of Ingeborg Bachmann, one of my favorite authors. This is from a speech of hers on public broadcasting, on broadcasting in general. In playing with the impossible, we extend what is possible. And there's something in this, because I personally think that what I've experienced at Republika in the past couple of days is exactly this. And I'm going to talk more about it from my personal perspective, which some of you may know. I consider my project as utopian negation. You can explain it theoretically, but some may know this, which is vastly more important. I show this every time because I want to watch it every time. And I can only say this talk is not going to get any better. I try, but it's not going to happen. There's simply too much competition. This is just too much competition, this video. But anyway, some bullet points. I wanted to list the 10 biggest insights, but lists aren't really my strong suit. I managed to get to 5 or 6, but that's when I ran out of ad roll. But I noticed some big terms. Some of them are very cliche. Some of them are cliche of social media or of conferences. But I think that we're serious about exchange at Republika. exchange is a very, yes, very important point. You learn something new, you share something of your own, you share opinions, or maybe you don't share opinions, you get talking to people. I personally have learned a lot of important things, a lot of things from new perspectives in the past few days. For instance, I learned this tweet to drink. Stupidly, I always got it the wrong way around, drink to tweet. Some of you may know that. But the good thing is that our exchanges are not simply about the internet. It's about the whole environment of the internet, about Berlin as a place where things are happening. I think you're still waiting for Wi-Fi, yeah. But I'm sure it's going to come at some point. But it's not going to make you a single bit happier, I can promise you that. But Berlin and its surroundings are important for me as a quarter New Yorker. Berlin is still considered very cool, but I learned in exchange in the past few days, people are worried as well, especially because of Berlin's culture, not only online culture, but also urban culture. I heard the word gentrification a few times, but I know that from my own time in Berlin. There were also attempts to beautify many things, but it really does seem like we've reached a new point in gentrification, because in my own time, ages ago, we had graffiti. But I noticed that's still around, but it looks a bit different these days. And all in all, I feel like graffiti is becoming more mainstream these days. And some developments, I'm a bit worried about some developments, but I have to congratulate you. But you may not have Wi-Fi, but at least you have a mall. That's great. But I thought it might get a new name, but it doesn't look like it. But when you walk through town, through this mall landscape, you notice some of the tensions in a city that's developing, that's changing. You don't seem to think very highly of dialectics. I'm worried that the library might not go as well as you think. It's to Berlin. Yeah, it's a bit antiquated. And there are some new difficulties appearing. This is something new, but you seem to be having a problem with Antifa yuppies, leftist yuppies. And I couldn't really fathom what that might look like, but then I took the underground and I immediately saw one. The good thing is there is still people are still fighting some very good old ways, where we have political statements. We're going to get you all RAF. And this can make you happy, but it may feel like this is a bit too late. The top of the poster says we've moved. So yeah, you have to work more quickly. That's a problem with the old media.
And another topic, community. Yeah, community. Nice word. We want to have that. But I see it exists here at Republika. Twitter is contributing to that, and you can don't say much bad things about Twitter. But community is there. And I see this every day. And at Republika, I have the feeling it's a lot of it has to do with Twitter, that all of you know each other so well. At least I think so. It is that way. This is from 2 days ago. Sascha Lobo, who are you? I was happy to see him again. Last year, I was a subsidiary for him, and this didn't work so well, but he covered me as well, and did a bit with negation, outcrossing this. A lot of speeches in the last few days were a bit empowering, a bit spiteful, yeah, talk. I see a lot of problems and worries and surveillance and a lot of other things, which are always very active, and one has to work at it, make people conscious about it, and it's, but it's easy to lose hope a bit. But just to, go, to get going, I thought it was inspirational. Even with this, with Never Give Up, I was very thankful for private talks that were a bit hopeful. I think you are a bit too pessimistic, he said. And I think that's a special feeling, this old cynic, who, this hobby anarchist, he gets hopeful, wants to take part and take courage, say something, and it inspires me to do tweets like this, that you see the world with other eyes and much more positive, and that's, it's nice if somebody is taking notice of that. But all in all, I must say thank you. The German Twitter community welcomed me nicely. Next point, theory and praxis. This practice, that's what I missed as an academic, this and. And much of what I noticed by Markus Mekedal, for example, there are big problems, concrete thoughts, and the try to make us hopeful, even if you have to fight with your own problems. And I don't think it's going to get better. Be creative, I thought would be the most important message with that. But in the practical sense, I thought it's all connected with TTIP, this secret documents. That this was at the Republika, I thought was very fitting, because it's a space, a community of people who understand how hard it is to do something like this, to put out your own message when you things are like this. But I see it got out pretty fine, people noticed it, some headlines, some a bit less, who are a bit less in awe, where this thing just said, where's the news? And America, Europe is very important. What I always tried to put out, and I think you are all a bit worried about American politics nowadays with Trump, but I have a very good news. And it's this. The bad news is that you may be willing to buy, and there are a bit of tensions. It's a bit disappointing when I read something like this. Many Germans think badly about America, but you have to go back to the practical and just say something like this. Many Germans think badly. That's very bad. Solidarity, the next topic. It's totally needed, and there's this connection, this addition, and going deeper with being together that that mostly goes about being online, but here we have the feeling we are getting together, being in solidarity because we are in contact with each other, because Twitter and Facebook are not really enough only to like and retweet. It's not enough to really get together with the topics of nowadays. And I think it's nice to have something like this, like Republika, to share with others and make plans. And I think that's very much needed, I have to say, sadly. After TTIP leaks, the Republika leaks, and I'm a bit worried for the future, what may come out. Maybe we are at fault because we are not being protective enough of our data, or it went out a bit at Republika leaks, that the conditions are not that optimal for everyone. But I was really happy with the owl burrito.
Too soon.
It came out, I read, that the audience of today got so far back from everybody that Kraftwerk is not really differentiable from craft beer, I thought, which was a bit sad. And this lounge area is maybe not as safe. I can see that may be problematic. Some things I don't really find are bad, but came out badly in the media. And we heard this new emoji we saw a few days ago for anyway is already occupied, and it's with this face. There are some similarities. Me, myself, I had to suffer with these leaks because my tour is not as ecologically friendly as it is. They saw my secret account, which is saying, oh yeah, or something. Some shameful stuff in the internet. No, a manifesto. Always bought together with tracking on Mallorca and privacy, my New York flat. They have seen it's a bit embarrassing. I try to make advertisement for Greek friends of me who are doing crowdfunding, which is Athens Live. You've seen 1,000 times on my page. And oh, there's this too. You're not supposed to see that. And we have they hacked our direct messages, and they have those now. And it's embarrassing because I try to make sure they are really hardworking and it's hard conditions. And then there's this beers over the last 2 days, which is a bit embarrassing. But the most embarrassing thing you're reading, I don't really like selfies. And yeah, at the Republika leaks, some things came out, and you're not very proud about it. This is most embarrassing. Not because of the face. Whoa, that's far too big. Oh, bad. Okay. Not because of the beautiful face, but because of the very bad pun to the right. Well, for the slogan, I had a much better idea, but they didn't take this. Next topic, we're at the end almost, networking. I have to say, what I see here in the last 2 days was really deepening, getting to know people online, and I'm very happy if I readily see thinking about the failed intellectuals. I think that's nice, and What I think about technology is not very positive. Technology is the deepest abyss on the flattest screen. I think about tweets not as bad on culture. And I'm very happy at Republika there are the right friends. And that was really nice. The other almost last topic, disappointment, I said it again. It could be something bad, but I think it's a very interesting word, because if you're not täuscht anymore and you're enttäuscht, I think that's good. And you could write a dark picture of it. But I think disappointment is very important, especially on the Republika, especially today. I saw yesterday the books on the best-selling lists on the first thing is Wunschdenken by right-wing author, visual thinking, right-wing author Thilo Sarrazin. But there's Snowden who disperses a lot of hope, but it's not all bad, because we had a selfie with him as well. But the other thing that's very important in politics, we've talked about in a lot of contexts, is the political changes, the march to the right in Germany and in some parts, in Austria as well, where there was a vote. And I saw a lot of this, and I think it's a big problem. And with these headlines, Austria is the icon for the CSU, the Conservative Party in Bavaria. And if you see, there are still positive initiatives from the net that should be supported, and this is some hope for me, even though me myself, I don't really like how the votes turned out. This is a new design for the Austrian flag. TV is bad, and there are plans for a new motto for Austria, which I don't find as nice. But at the end, there's hope. It's a big word. I think it's nice, and I hope it still exists after Republika. You can have courage, you can dream, and I hope that even with the super unrealistic dreams, they don't stay that way, which is snapshots for grown-ups. And I hope you are really successful with this. I just have a really small need. I really like umlauts, which are endangered. The most with Uber. Yeah, they were everywhere, but now it's a bit harder. And some are really evil. But I'm at the end because there are more important topics. For example, this. But at the end, one word of encouragement sent by Kafka. Twitter is dead, don't do it. Skip to Instagram. One word by Kafka. Leave open this account, because our rescue is dead. Death, but not this. Thank you. This is a pun about Auf Wiedersehen, which is, of course, goodbye, with an owl. Because why not?